A third Canadian has been detained in China after two others, former diplomat Michael Kovrig and entrepreneur Michael Spavor, were detained last week amid diplomatic tensions between Canada and China. Following the arrest of Chinese telecom giants Huawei CFO Meng Wanzhou in Vancouver. But a Canadian government official says there's no reason to believe that the latest case is linked to the previous detentions of Canadians in China. A government spokesperson saying in a statement today, Global Affairs Canada is aware of a Canadian citizen detained in China. Consular officials are providing assistance to the family. Due to the provisions under the Privacy Act, no further information can be disclosed.
We are, of course, taking any and every situation seriously, as we always do. But we are looking into the details on this most recent one that doesn't seem to fit the pattern set by the previous two. But we'll have more to say as we collect the facts on this issue.
It's widely believed the detention of Kovrig and Spavor is in retaliation to Meng's December 1st arrest at the request of the U.S. She's now out on bail in Vancouver, facing possible extradition to the U.S. on charges of violating American sanctions on Iran. Meng denies the allegations. Beijing has threatened unspecified consequences in the wake of the Huawei exec's arrest. Paul Evans, an expert on Asia-Canada relations at the University of British Columbia, sitting down with China Global Television Network last week, weighing in on the complicated position Canada now finds itself in.
This is the beginning of something that Canadians are extremely nervous about, that the United States would not just go after companies they don't like, but after individuals. But that's why this is not just a Huawei story. It's not just a Canada-China story. It's a where the U.S. is going to go in pushing China and in its new approach to advancing America first.
Let's get back to Justin Trudeau. The Prime Minister was asked several questions today about the situation with China. I want to leave you with his response to the question, why don't you publicly demand the release of the Canadians? And at what point would you consider reaching out to the Chinese president? Here's some of what he had to say.
We have engaged in a very, very thoughtful way on trying to get the best outcome. And sometimes politicizing or amplifying the level of public discourse on this may be satisfying in the short term, but would not contribute to the outcome we all want, which is for Canadians to be safe and secure.